Hi, Karen Ferris, in the beautiful Prince's Park on a fresh, sunny Melbourne day. So this week I'm talking about adaptive leadership. And leaders need to be adaptive in this volatile, uncertain, complex and ambiguous world of change that we're living in. They need to be able to change direction very quickly and bring their teams with them on that journey. And one of the things they need to do is to create a diversity of thought, to be able to respond, sense and respond to the world changing around them. And they need to say, when I don't know, and ask for support, be vulnerable, be authentic, and get a diversity of views from their teams and other teams in the organisation. And a great example of that diversity of thinking and inclusion was Abraham Lincoln, when he was elected to the presidency of the United States. And he had some stern opposition, and I can't remember the names of all the opposition now. There's three or four of them, and they're in my book. I think Ian Stewart was one of them. And it was a surprise to them all when Abraham Lincoln got elected, because he was from the wrong side of the tracks, and people weren't putting the money on Abraham getting in. But when he created his cabinet, he actually included his adversaries in his cabinet. And he was asked why he could do that. He said, well, he looked around and he was looking for strong leaders and, you know, diversity of opinions, and they were the people. And he said they were powerful leaders and that the country deserved powerful leaders. So he brought his adversaries into his cabinet and embraced their ideas, if you like. So adaptive leaders need to do the same. Embrace a diversity of views and thinking. Another video of adaptive leadership tomorrow.